take on board as we do reforms, especially in the judicial system regarding children's issues. The first thing that I'll be taking home again with me is that I've been asked to prepare for a forum of this kind, like at home, which will inform other stakeholders who did not have the opportunity to have been at this conference. We come up here with all those outcomes, then it is for us to take them and see how we use them, you know, to improve people's lives.
I am Rose Atieno Pio, a lecturer at the Department of Education Psychology, Masinde Muliro University and Science and Technology. I also work as a mental health specialist for children, and I was a delegate in this conference. I have presented two papers. One of my paper was talking about how school breeds criminal and offending behavior, and the other paper that I also presented is about children of imprisoned mothers in Kakamega Women Prison in Western Kenya. So I found these two papers really relevant for the conference, which was meant to be best interests of children. And actually the presentations alongside mine has allowed me to gain a lot of experience of how we can really come to safeguard the interests of children in the justice system.
This conference was put together because we felt this is the moment of reform in the children's matter in Kenya today. The children agenda required to be reviewed. It is a matter of concern that since the constitution was promulgated in 2010, all other sectors have undergone tremendous reforms and the reviews of their registrations and policies, but very little has been done for children. But it is just as well that it is coming after everybody else has done their reforms, because then it is gathering a lot of momentum, a lot of interest, because we also find ourselves challenged by many issues that are affecting children today. It has emerged from this workshop that over 80% of cases of children delinquency and children in contact with the law ought not to be brought through the formal justice system. This is a matter of concern because it looks like there is a failure of systems in our society. It's a failure of child support and protection system within the families, that the families do not understand who is a child and what kind of protection they can offer them. Not only the family, but also the community at large, the religious bodies who are supposed to also inculcate values into our children so that they can grow into responsible people who learn values that guide them in their lives.
So having taken an overview of everything that we've heard over the last 3 days and from all the different countries, we've heard from civil, criminal and administrative areas of law. So each of those areas has got their own particular areas to be developed, but running across civil, criminal and administrative are issues of fair trial, particularly during the investigative process, how evidence is collected, how research is used, and how that affects the outcomes for children. I think we've also identified areas where we can work for better procedures and processes for best practice.
The kind of those kinds of papers that it can inform the judiciary on really what we need. And of course, the other stakeholders. There's someone out there going to our registries, pull out those files, and tell us as it is, and paint that picture as it is, so that we can wake up. If yes, that was one thing. But if you bring us 100, 200, 300, we are wake up call for the juvenile justice system in this country to really stand up and do what they're supposed to do. Secondly, the Children's Act. I want to make a plea for every Kenyan delegate sitting in this room who says they are champions for children's rights, who says that they support the best interests of the child, to just go and read that law.
And we look at the human rights standards on children at number 8 of 2001, we find that mixing these children with their mothers in their wards and lack of facilities to handle them, and some of them go back to society. What are we impacting for these children? Because if they are not sharing and talking, there's something there, learning through the environment. And maybe we might be making bigger failures by attacking these children with the mothers who are offenders.